What is supervision? In the last part, we understood what directing is and what the principles of directing are. In this part, we will address the first of the four elements of directing, namely supervision and what is supervision. Supervision is a workplace activity in which a manager oversees the activities and responsibilities of employees he manages. It's an important job function for managers at all levels throughout your company. Coaching, training, and employee development are among the common responsibilities assumed by a supervisor. The purpose of supervision is a process is to provide a safe and supportive opportunity for individuals to engage in critical reflection in order to raise issues, explore problems, and discover new ways of handling both the situation and oneself. A supervisor educates his people. Supervision is one of the elements of direction besides motivation, leadership, and communication. It is performed at all levels of management, as it means guiding the efforts of employees and other resources to achieve the desired output. Supervisors communicate with workers and perform all the managerial functions of planning, organizing, staffing, and controlling their activities. They act between two forces, that is managers and workers, and try to satisfy the need and desires of both managers and workers. Managers at the top supervise activities of middle-level managers who supervise the activities of lower-level managers who finally supervise the conduct of non-managers, that is, employees or workers of the organization. What are the objectives and functions of supervision? The first is ensures issuing instructions. The supervisor makes sure that all the instructions are communicated to each employee. The top level and middle level plan out the instructions, but the instructions are issued only by the supervisory level management. The second is to promote communication. That is, managers understand workers' goals and workers understand organization goals. Promote motivation. We will deal with this topic in a later part. The third is evaluate performance, that determines compensation and rewards. Improve performance, guide, coach, etc. to get the best out of the team. The fourth is discipline. A strict supervision and guidance of supervisor encourages employee and workers to be more disciplined in their activities. Fifth is feedback. Supervisors are directly dealing with subordinates, so they are the best persons to give feedback of subordinates. The supervisor gives the feedback regarding complaints, grievances, and problems of subordinates to superiors. The sixth is maintaining group unity. Supervisor plays a key role in maintaining group unity among workers. Working under him, he maintains harmony among workers by solving their disputes. This brings us to the end of the second part of directing, where we understood what is supervision and what a supervisor does. In the next three parts, we will understand the other three of the four elements of directing, namely communicating, motivating, and leadership. Thank you.